day delay in testing by the CDC. That's 10 doublings. 2 to the power of 10 is 1,024, which means that if we had 2 infections at the beginning of this, and now we have 1,024 infections. So the CDC's delay in this has allowed 2 infections in America to become 1,000 plus infections in America. This was done on purpose. That's the power of exponential growth.
And that's incredible. So the headline is, the takeaway is, CDC intentionally allows at least 1,000 infections.
Well, I mean, that's 1,000 infections for every 2 people who were infected. So if there, you know, if there were 200 people, you know, then we have 10,000 plus infections. This, I think right now, conservatively, we have, you know, what, 4,000 infections in America, conservatively right now. We just haven't been testing it. But the power of exponential growth, actually, I should have said, if it's 200 infections, it might be over 100,000 now, right now, in America. And you can add the right number of zeros. But look, this is out of control. And the CDC has done a great disservice to America in setting a trap for Trump. They prohibited local labs from doing the testing. And I remember, well, and Governor Newsom now says they don't have enough test kits in California. Yeah, I've been saying that here on InfoWars for weeks. And people said, oh, that's a conspiracy theory. You know, even a caller called into Rush Limbaugh the other day, and Rush said, didn't believe it. Well, Rush is going to have to apologize to his listeners real soon, because this is real. These numbers are real. This thing is exponential, and it's in California.
Well, Mike, we know they cover up the testing. Is there any other reason they would have done this other than wanting to incubate? What are the other possible reasons?
Well, the CDC gets enormous funding the bigger this emergency becomes, and they get to declare medical martial law. So we're talking about quarantines now. And guess who's going to be in charge of the quarantines? The vaccine people inside the government. And then, oh, look, here's a story today where you've got a, where is it? You've got experts now that say that you should be disallowed to fly if you don't have a coronavirus vaccine. Listen, that was on Yahoo News this morning. I've got it here somewhere, but you shouldn't be allowed to even fly. So now they're going to have mandatory vaccines. You'll be denied access to public transportation and who knows what else, because you're not getting the vaccine. And this vaccine is not even going to be safe, because it'll be rushed. They'll have no quality control. And it might be the
last time they get it. And those of us that don't take it will be the bad guys, we're told.
Yeah, exactly. And this gives the CDC the justification to call for the arrest and imprisonment of anti-vaxxers, saying that those individuals are getting people killed. And in fact, it is the bioweapons death science people that Francis Boyle put this out. Those are the people that are getting us all killed. And it's the same people running the vaccine industry. They're going to get us killed while they claim to be our savior. That's what's happening, Alex.
All right, Mike Adams, I'm going to do 5 more minutes with you. I know you've got your guest coming up in my interview with a member of the Brazilian Congress, Mr. Bolsonaro, will be coming up as well in the last segment of the next hour. We have another special guest. I'll be back at the ATX tonight. Stay with us at InfoWars.com.